Welcome everyone. Today we are going to see facing program creating in NX by using floor wall concept. First we need to set MCS, that is manufacturing coordinate system. We need to select the specify MCS. As per our requirement, we can able to set the reference point in another any edge point, origin of folds, center of the part, anything as per our requirement we can able to set that MCS. The toolpath created based on this MCS only. And in this here we have clearance values, that safe clearance distance. This is the non-cutting movements of the toolpath. Every toolpath in movement is arrived based on these things. The retraction values we can set it 100. Now we need to select the workpiece and blank. Need to select right click and edit. Here we need to select specific part first. Our workpiece we need to select it. Click OK. Then we need to select specific blank. Here in case we have it model of specific blank, we need to create the type of geometry, we can select it. Otherwise we can able to control the based on that NX subtype. Now we plan to select part outline. Here that blank is created on part outlines. We can able to control the Z value by clicking Z term plus direction. We can set it 5 mm. Now you see that our workpiece and blank is various from 5 mm and Z plus mm. Click OK. So now we set it MCS and workpiece. Go to the operation, right click on it, workpiece, insert, click operation. Here in this list we have a type of mill planner, we need to select it first. Then in operation sequence we need to select floor and wall. This process is used to create floor and wall based on the wall geometries. We need to select the specific cut area. Specific cut area geometry. Click on it, top face of that part. Click OK. Then we need to create a tool. We plan to create a tool for dia 100 face mill. So give the name of that. The tool spec we can edit it. The diamonds dia 300. Here in this list tools available, we can enable. Here we use the face milling tool. So how much insert they are available, we need to enter it. And tool number, that based on ATC changing. Then adjuster register is H value, height offset. Then customer registration is compensation registration number.
We need to add the cold head details. Dia 100 face mill cold head we need to set on 125 to 130 taper holder with 100 mm length. Which type of tool we have used it, we can able to customize in this tab. Need to set the tool axis. Here normal to first phase is available. We can set is Z term plus direction. Now we generate the toolpath. The toolpath is generated. Now you see that cut pattern is sig is already set it. So sig means every single pass as the tool is retract and again go to the origin point and again red passes. Every passes is separately running. Only one direction only is this tool path is moved. This is the concept of zig cut patterns. Now we plan to change the cut patterns. Select the cut patterns here. Some subtypes are available. We can able to control it as per our requirement. Like that subtype is follow part, follow peri peri, profile, crocodile, zigzag, zig with contour. Now we plan to select it follow part, generate the tool path. Now you can see that how the part is available, that profile based the pacing is arrived. Here we have rectangle square so that only their toolpath is created rectangular and the every toolpath is outer to inward is automatically arrived. This toolpath is engaged in outer. Now we that toolpath is running part of the profile. Based on our requirement, we can able to change that cut patterns. Now we plan to check that follow periphery, regenerate the toolpath. Now verify the toolpath. The tool is engaged in the middle of the part. And its cut movement is zig. All profile based, it's moving. Here we see that the tool is engaged middle of the part is not for safe. So we can able to control it the engaging the tool path of follow periphery cut pattern. That is we plan to check it cutting parameters. Click it. Here we can see that cutting strategy is cutting cut direction clip cut and the pad direction is we can able to change it. Outward is already available. We plan to change it at inward. Now regenerate the toolpath. Now you can see that the tool is engaged it outside of the part. So safest to side of engagement we can able to control it. Now we plan to check it profile cut pattern. Actually in this floor wall concept, in case we have it any wall, that type only is possible to use this profile concept. The part cannot be faced at any levels.
So any other wall is arrived means so that only we can able to check it on profile. Then crocodile also we can able to check, get it toolpath, but it's not perfect to use on the face milling process. This is we can able to use it for roughing profile. We can use this crocodile concept. Otherwise facing concept we don't need to use this, and is much more difficult to general toolpaths. So normally the crocodile milling concept of cut pattern is no need to use that. The next type of cut patterns, zig type, already we can see it. So zigzag we plan to check it, regenerate the toolpath, need to verify the toolpath. The tool engages outer side of the toolpath. The tool moved, that cut direction is zigzag. Here you can see that the tool is climp cut and conventional cut, both milling is here running. Here then the step over is available, we can able to control is the every single path, how is concept of that moving, that scale of constant, tool percentage, which type we need, we can able to variable passes, we can able to control it. Now we plan to set that percentage up to 75%, we can plan to move. Here we have 8 tool paths for 75%. In case we change it at 50, we have it 11 passes. So this type of we can able to control it, that passes, how number of passes is need to facing.
And the next we have it floor blank thickness. The how much this thickness we can able to control it. In case we need 5 mm means we can set it. And the depth of cut, here I plan to 1 mm. So raw material thickness was 5 mm, depth of cut is 1 mm. So totally 5 passes here arrived, right? So this type of how much our raw material available, we can able to control that. And depth of cut also can be able to control in NX. The zigzag movement is mostly used for facing program. And here we can able to control the feed and feed speed. Select the tab. Set the BC values and click OK. We can get as per requirement speed and feed. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to RK CAD CAM.